So hello, good morning everyone to the students, faculty, and librarians po present on this EBSCO online training session po for May Kawayan College. Then here with me po is si Sir Alvin Solitario, your chief librarian po, to help me or assist me with regards po to your questions po. I'll be giving webinar guidelines po later on my slides for us to navigate further with this WebEx platform. So if there will be students or faculty po na hindi makapasok po with this WebEx orientation, this is currently streamed live po sa account po ni Sir Alvin, which will be shared to the May Kawayan College library page. Okay po? So to start with, I would like to welcome you all to the EBSCO Resources online training orientation po, wherein we will be navigating EBSCO host platforms and resources that is being subscribed by May Kawayan College. Of course, to start this orientation, let us put ourselves in the presence of the Lord for our Lord to give us guidance and providence. In the name of the Father, of the Son, of the Holy Spirit, Amen. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, as we gather here in this morning, we ask you to bless our speaker and all of the participants with this webinar. We thank you for being our refuge, our strength, and our ever-present help, most especially in these times of pandemic. Please continue to guide all of us in everything we say and do, because all of this we do for you. In Jesus' name we always pray, Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, Amen. So again, good morning everyone, and I would like to welcome you all again to the EBSCO Resources online training session for May Kawayan College. Actually, as a matter of fact, I always do this on a yearly basis to May Kawayan College on a physical manner. But because of this pandemic po, so ginagawa na po natin siya online. So, hindi ko na po ituturn on ng video ko. Later ko na lang ituturn on ng video ko, maybe during question and answer, para at least mas smooth flow lang po yung ating online training po. Para at least dito lang po kayo nakafocus po sa slide. Okay, and by the way, my name is Bonse Gisabal. I'm your information consultant for the Philippines of EBSCO Information Services. Then I'll be facilitating this online training session through WebEx platform po, which is streamed live in Facebook. Okay, so first, I would like to give everyone our webinar guidelines for you to be familiarized as well with WebEx and how we could engage you as the participant. First, as a participant, all of your microphones and videos are turned off by default. So it's only Sir Alvin and I ang meron lang pong opportunity or privilege to mute and unmute ourselves for certain announcements po and to turn on our videos. For participant, you cannot do it po for the sake of syempre mga background noise, etc. So if you have questions on this orientation, please type it on your designated Q&A box found at the lower right-hand side of your screen. So there is a Q&A box there. Kung hindi nyo po yun makita yon, just send a message po to the chat box and makikita rin po namin yun both ni Sir Alvin. So again, as what I have mentioned, the questions for this orientation will be read at the end of the presentation. And of course, this will ensure a smooth flow and of course not to interrupt me while I'm doing the orientation itself. Sit back, listen, and have a fun learning experience with us. So again, good morning. My name is Bonse Gisabal. Here are my contact information. So if you have questions po na hindi ma-address with regards to this training session today, please feel free to reach out to my email, landline, and my mobile. But first, of course through your question, of course, to your librarian, which is Sir Alvin Solitario po. And again, I would like to welcome you all and thank you for joining this today's session. This training agenda actually will run for an hour, and the first 40 minutes, we will be discussing about the EBSCO host research databases na sinubscribe po ng May Kawayan College together with Academic Search Elite. Then we will be launching the EBSCO host, the new EBSCO mobile app for our users. And then next 20 minutes, we'll be discussing how you could download ebooks or the EBSCO ebooks, how you would search ebooks, how you will read ebooks, and how you will be downloading ebooks. Then the last 10 minutes will be the interfaces po for the basic education. Meron din po tayo later sa basic education or sa high school department this afternoon. But for the sake of your information po, so I'll be discussing very briefly lang dun sa our Explora platform that contains the basic education databases, Mass Ultra, and primary search. Then the latter part of the minute or minutes, the latter part of the session will be intended to answer questions po for the participants. Okay? Okay, so to start with, so here are the different features available in EBSCOhost po. So I'll not be dwelling much on the boolean on the command line and field operators. I'll be just focusing primarily to the most used, which is the boolean operator. Na i-discuss ko po later with regards to this presentation po. Then I will also be discussing about search histories, and we will be also papakita ko din po on how you could do your own search alert and how you could do as well your journal alerts, and how you would save your searches through your My EBSCOhost folder na gagawin din po natin later on po at the end of the session. Okay, so now let me proceed to the 5 key steps in EBSCOhost. So these 5 key steps are being used or being for you to have a successful search. So first is, of course, on how you would create your search term. So think about how you would structure your search by the proper use of truncation and Boolean operators. And again, in creating your own search term, ituturo ko sa inyo later kung paano kayo makakagawa ng words through the use of Boolean operators and how you would truncate further your search term po. Then of course, after creating your search term, we have what we call facets. These facets naman, or called limiters, is being used to focus your search and of course to refine down your results. And after limiting your results are being presented to you, and of course the results could either be you're looking into full text content or custom links, but this is for the discovery service. The full text po could have two formats. It could be HTML full text or in PDF full text na ipapakita ko sa inyo later in my live demo. So doon naman po sa ating upon downloading or having the full text content, you have now as well the option to create your own personalized folder or your My EBSCOhost folder, wherein you could have the privilege to collect your articles and to store them to access these articles for future session and to save them permanently. Then upon creation of your folder, you could now have as well the privilege to save, of course, aside from saving your articles, for you to create your own search alert and your journal alert, okay? So moving forward, let me refresh everyone. I think the library has done its efforts to do in library instruction to teach everyone about Boolean operators. Boolean operators, tatlo lang naman po yan, it's and, or not. And or not are being typed in or keyed in the search box in capital letters. Why? Because if you don't key in capital letters, this will be identified by by EBSCOhost as a search term and not a Boolean operator. So how do we use and? And po is used between the terms to narrow down our search. So for example, if you are using or if you are searching something about diabetes and obesity, that will retrieve you references, of course, containing both of the search term. And of course, yung relation po nitong search terms po din nyo. Traditionally kasi what we do, you search for diabetes, get results. Search for obesity, get results. Wherein you could search both search terms by using and Boolean operator, and you will be helped on the different articles po about these two search topics. And if you want naman to broaden down your search, you could use or Boolean operator, and that will provide you references containing either of the search term relevant or not relevant with one another. Then lastly, you will use not Boolean operator to omit a term for your search. So for example, if you are a student that you are searching for risk factors of lung cancer, but you want to exclude smoking as a risk factor, you could include you could put not Boolean operator. So you could key in like lung cancer not smoking, and that will retrieve your references containing the term or the topic lung cancer and its related articles, but it will omit the relevant articles of smoking kasi yun yung in-exclude po ninyo with your search term. So, we'll try to do a search term later with the use of Boolean operators and of course the search tips that I'll be discussing on my next slide. Okay, so here are some of the search tips. So if you have your pen and paper with you, hopefully you could take note of this. This will help you to further maximize your the use of the EBSCOhost platform. So first is the use of truncation and word stemming device. So ang ginagamit po natin dyan na punctuation mark is an asterisk. Because your search term might have, of course, our search terms has its root word and its suffixes. Okay? So for example, if you want to search for articles related to dyslexia, and if you keyed in dyslexia in the EBSCOhost platform, what will happen? It will only retrieve you articles related to dyslexia, but not dyslexia as a root word and its suffixes. So for example, if you truncate dyslexia, so you put dyslexia with an asterisk, that will provide you results not only for dyslexia, but its root word and suffix. So it could be dyslexia, dyslexic, etc. It could also be your topics in plural form. So for example, if you're searching for, let's say, flower, and you truncate it, okay po? You truncate flower and yung truncate it using an asterisk, pwede nyo pong makuha ng mga search terms po dyan like flower, flowery, flowers, and yung ano niya, yung kanyang plural form. So with the proper use of truncation, it will help you to search and maximize the articles inside the database. Next naman po is the single and the multiple character wildcard. So ang ginagamit naman po natin dyan is yung question mark and hashtag. So bakit naman po gumagamit pa tayo ng mga single and multiple character wildcard? Because there are instances po that our search term is written in British or American English. Kung mapapansin niyo sa example, organization and organization, pareho lang naman po ang meaning po ng dalawa na 'yan. Pero ang pinagkaiba lang po niyan, as of course aside from spelling, it is being written, it's either or written in British or American English, but both has the same meaning. So for you to maximize the result of the database, so gawin nyo po yung single character wildcard. Same thing with color and color, pareho lang yung meaning, pero of course, it is being written, it's either British or American English. And aside from that, lastly, last search tip that I would like to provide you is the proper use of quotation marks or what we call phrase searching. So, ang ginagamit natin dyan is quotation marks. So, it's not only we search for like single words, but we sometimes search for 2 to 3 phrases in our search box. So, for a typical example, it's like global warming. So, it's 2 words. And if you put quotation marks, so that will retrieve your references containing both of the search term next to each other in exact order. However, if you don't put quotation marks traditionally with 2 to 3 word phrases, ganito po yung example ng result na makukuha ninyo. The global phenomenon, blah, 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 warming, blah, blah, blah. So, ibig sabihin, hindi niya talaga kinukuha yung global warming as a word. And I guess some of you had experienced that. But ngayon po kasi, very sophisticated and innovative na ng ating mga platform that it already identifies common phrases already, which is like example ng global warming, even though we didn't put quotation marks. Okay? So hopefully, these search tips will be very useful for you in creating focus and targeted searches and para ma-maximize nyo rin po yung database. And I would like as well to take this opportunity to launch our new EBSCO mobile app. So this EBSCO mobile app, meron na kami before na EBSCOhost mobile app, but ngayon po kasi is meron kaming in-overhaul namin ang ating EBSCO mobile app. And this EBSCO mobile app po is downloadable in App Store or in Google Play Store. So type nyo lang po EBSCO. The first result, yung kulay blue po na app, yun po yung bagong EBSCO mobile app. So, ano naman po magagawa nyo po with the EBSCO mobile app? Okay, so you could find and connect with your library using geolocation. So, ano bang ibig sabihin nun? If you type it, let's say, May Kawayan College, so hahanapin niya po doon. Or let's say, type nyo lang po dyan Philippines, or type nyo lang po dyan Bulacan, lalabas po yung mga institution na subscriber namin right from your mobile device. So pwede nyo po siyang gawin. Then upon signing in to the institution po na nasa inyo po, you could choose from your research searches or you could also enter a new search from here. And you could also use the Boolean operators po from here sa pag-search nyo po dito. And aside from that, so you just the screenshots po of the EBSCO mobile app. You could save your items po. Yan. So meron din po tayong quick filter if you only want to have full text. Then ang maganda dito, right through your mobile app, you could browse already the full text content right from the mobile app. Let me reiterate ha, this is a mobile app. This is not something about on your mobile browser. This is a dedicated mobile app. Then of course, there's a dynamic content landing page. Baka may magtanong later, so sasagutin ko na. Sir Bon, yung e-books ba na meron kami sa May Kawayan College will be downloaded and can be read through the mobile app. For now, to set expectation, it is not yet available. So ang sabi po sa amin, by last quarter of this year or early next year, that will be an enhancement of the mobile app. So please stay tuned po for that. Kasi for now, ang ide-demo ko po for downloading po the e-books is the Adobe Digital Editions for now, which I also demo po or na-train ko po ito, I think last year din po sa mga faculty ng May Kawayan College. So again, this is just a refresher and this is just an update that we do now have the EBSCO mobile app. Then moving forward, so as what I have mentioned, we have also a dedicated interface for our basic education called Explora. And this Explora platform, dalawa lang po ang meron po kayo. It's primary and secondary school. This is primarily, of course, to support your basic education for your, ano po yan, for your high school and at the same time po, yung ano nyo po, yung elementary din po as well. Then, ang maganda po sa ating Explora platform, if it has what we call topic overviews, na primarily, i-discuss ko din po on the latter part of this presentation. So ito po yung interface ng Explora platform. Okay. So to move on, so here are the databases being subscribed by May Kawayan College. So you have an access to Academic Search Elite. So this is a multidisciplinary database. And yung Funk and Wagnalls Mass Ultra Primary Search po, these are the databases po for your basic education. Then Eric po, kung familiar, kung nasa education or education po ang inyong course program, so ERIC po stands for the Education Resources Information Center. So you have also an access to this database. Then we have LISTA or the Library of Science and Technology Abstracts and the EBSCO Open Dissertations for grad school. And the good thing about this is in one search platform, you have an access to the EBSCO eBooks Academic Subscription Collection. So to give you an idea in terms of its content sa mga faculty po na nandito rin po. So our data, the database subscribed by May Kawayan po is Academic Search Elite, which is multidisciplinary. Currently, it has almost 1,500 full-text journals po. And this content is updated daily. Then your major ebook database naman is the Subscription Academic Collection that contains almost 100 na, actually now it's 197,000 ebooks na po. That offers unlimited user access and wherein you could download as well the offline of the ebook. So later papakita ko sa inyo kung paano yan dina-download for offline use. And being multidisciplinary in nature po, so ayan po yung mga different subject areas being covered by this ebook collection po. Okay. So for security purposes, so I am not be posting in my slides the login credentials that will be provided for faculty and students of the different colleges. Please reach out to Sir Alvin Solitario and get your logins po sa kanya. Okay, kasi meron kaming different user groups. Iba po ang access per college and iba rin po ang access per student. Iba po ang access ng student and iba rin ng faculty. This is primarily for us to monitor the usage of every college and every student and faculty of that college. So I think Sir Alvin is here now in WebEx. So if you could, I think pwede kayong magtanong right now kay Sir Alvin through sa chat box po for you to get your own logins, or pwede nyo din po siyang i-message po sa page ng May Kawayan College Library Facebook page or sa mismong account niya po. Okay? So now let's do the platform demo po. Okay, wait lang po ha. I'll just transition po my slides. Okay, before I proceed, our URL is search.ebscohost.com po ha. So ito yung ikikiin po ninyo. Ito po yung website kung saan nyo po ikikiin yung inyong user ID and password. So let me move. Okay. Okay, so here in this page, so nandito na po ako sa search.ebscohost.com. Okay, then I'll be keying in to the user ID and password for May Kawayan College. So again, the user ID and password po is specific po for your college and is specific whether you are a faculty or you're a student. Again, we have updated the logins already, so please reach out with Sir Alvin Solitario for you to get your user ID and password of your college. So if I click sign in, I will be redirected to this page. Okay, so makikita nyo naman that this is a subscription of May Kawayan. Kasi syempre, nandiyan po yung May Kawayan College. And ang una nyo pong makikita po dito is the three interface, the interfaces of EBSCOhost and Explora. Again, Explora is for your basic education. Nakalagay naman po yung grade level ng content po na yan. I'll focus primarily on the EBSCOhost Research Database. So if I click that, so I will be redirected to this page. Okay, so zoom ko lang po para sa mga naka-stream po sa ating Facebook Live para makita nyo lang siya ng malaki. Okay, so makikita nyo naman po, this is a very straightforward interface, the logo of May Kawayan for branding purposes. And because kaya ganito po yung setup ng EBSCO, because we want our users to feel the Google-like experience. Meron lang single search box and you could move on to your search. But for the sake of this training presentation, we will be navigating this basic search page. So we have this new search button here. You could also do your subject search through these different databases. You could always do publication search. Okay. Iba po yung pagsa-search dito at pagsa-search po through publications. Sa publications po, you are looking for a particular journal title. Okay? So, kung gusto ko naghanap kayo ng particular journal, you could always look for these databases. Again, our academic search, ito yung multidisciplinary. You could also search for images, and there's a built-in dictionary here from American Oxford and American Heritage Children's Dictionary. We have also indexes here. So, ang index naman po na yan, you could go in here to check if the particular journal is being indexed through our database po. Then if you only want to access ebooks, you could go to more, go to ebooks, then click nyo lang po yung ebook academic collection because if you click that, you could only now search ebooks through this platform. So pansin nyo nag-iba siya kasi ang finocus lang niya po ngayon are ebooks. Pero hindi ko po yan gagawin kasi gusto ko pong pakita sa inyo that you could access journals and ebooks po in one platform. Then on the right hand corner of your screen, meron ditong sign in. This is signing into your folder and this is your temporary folder. Pag naka-sign in po kasi kayo, mag-merge po yung dalawa na yan. Magiging sign out po ito and this would be your named EBSCOs folder. We have here preferences. Pwede nyo pong baguhin kung ano yung itsura ng nakikita nyo po for personalization. Pero lagi kong sinasabi on my training session po that the preferences or the default preferences is okay. You could also transform this the interface language through these different languages po. Then at the end of this orientation, Sir Bon, very informative yung training, pero I am information overload. You could always go back to a more detailed tutorial from the help function. If you click help, so ang laki niya, wait lang. Yan, if you click help, it will open the EBSCOhost complete online help system. So ayun po yung kinaganda dyan. You could also browse tutorials, then yung mga details po na nandito. Again, may mga tutorial videos tayo if you want to go really in-depth or in-detail of this. Okay, then let's proceed na po to this search box. So if you click show all, so ayan po lahat ng database na sinesearch nyo po right now. And if you click choose databases, you could select and deselect the different titles po available po na nandito. So pipili-piliin natin siya lahat. Okay? Then, meron din po akong bibigay sa inyo na Okay, may bibigay rin po ako sa inyo na another search tip. So from here, so if you want to see the description of the databases, meron po tayo ditong preview icon that if you hover your mouse here, nyari let's say sa Academic Search Elite, okay, makikita nyo po, nalalabas po yung description ng databases. So you could go over it at lahat naman po sinelect natin. Okay, now let's do a search. So for example, I am searching for particular, okay, meron pong, magsa-search po ako right now of a searcher, maybe I want to search for something about the impact maybe of articles about social media. So pansin nyo po, as I key in my search term, this is what we call autocomplete function. So pinapakita nyo na po yung possible na search term na gusto mong i-type or i-search. So pansin nyo po, I will not be using phrase searching. So pakita rin sa inyo na sophisticated ng ating platform that it identifies already two-word phrases po na mostly common na two-word phrases. And if I click search, okay, so makikita po ninyo dito, if I click social media, so I will be redirected po to this result page. Again, the first key step is creating your, in EBSCO, is creating your search term. Second, we move to facets, okay? So ang facets po natin is what we call limiters. So ito yan siya. So you could always limit your results to full text or if downloads are available. Wait lang. Bakit naka-ebook lang ako? Sorry, isa-select ko lahat ha. I think I've selected everything. Okay. Ayan, kasi kanina puro e-books lang pala yung nakikita natin. But anyway, so upon clicking social media, so mapapansin po ninyo na the next key step would be facets or delimiters. So on the left-hand corner, you could limit your results if you want to full text only, scholarly journals, publication dates. Okay, nandiyan naman po yan. Then, if you further scroll down, so makikita rin nyo po dito yung different source types. So if you click show more, you will be redirected to the different source types available in your database. So the good thing about this, you could see that it doesn't only have academic journals, it has also magazines, reports, trade publications, ebook, dissertations, books, etc. You could always filter kung gusto nyo lang academic journals, gusto nyo lang ebooks, etc. Scrolling down, you could further filter it down through the different subjects or subject terms or thesaurus term, further subject areas that will lead you to more detailed subjects po. Then you could also filter through the different publications. So upon showing you the publications po, ang ibig sabihin niyan, the articles being presented po to you in the results list came from this different publication ranging from the New York Times, Wall Street Journal, Journal of Medical Internet Research, Time Magazine, Journal of Association of Information Science, etc. If you further scroll down and if you click Publisher, if you click Show More, ato, sa mga faculty po na nagtatanong, Sir Bon, meron po ba dyang articles na pinublish ni Taylor and Francis ni Elsevier? Dito nyo po siya makikita sa Publisher. So if you want only Taylor and Francis published articles, so filter nyo lang yan. So we have 11,700 articles po from Taylor and Francis. We have from Elsevier, Wiley, Routledge, Scholastic, etc. You could also further filter down through companies and language. Okay, to set expectation, not all our results are available po in English language. But 90 to 95 of them is English naman. But if you don't want to see Spanish, Portuguese, Turkish articles, so filter nyo lang po siya dyan. Still, kung makikita nyo, English articles pa rin naman yung pinakamarami. Aside from that, you could also further filter down to geography, industry, different categories po, and the universities being involved in that particular article, and of course, the different databases na meron ng May Kawayan College. Scroll down po natin, scroll up natin ha. So again, ano po yung third result natin? Sorry. Ano yung ating third result? Ang third result, ang third key step natin is navigating the result. Okay. The results po are ranked in relevance. So if you click relevance, so pansin nyo, ayan ang kanyang default. But you could always filter if you want newest content or oldest content. But I would like to always mention that that not all new articles will be relevant to your search term. So let's just trust the algorithm po of EBSCO in terms of its relevance para po makita po ninyo kung ano po talaga yung relevance sa inyong search term. The good thing about this is your first result is an ebook. Okay, kita nyo po ang ebook pa yan, social media ebook, but we have also video results. So these videos came from Associated Press, and these videos po again are not downloadable. They are only viewable online, but you could browse the transcript. So AP for Associated Press are just mini news clips po ito. Mini news clips po ito that may be relevant to your search term. Okay, so we have also reference. Pag-reference po yan, galing po yan sa encyclopedia, which came from Funk and Wagnalls po. So again, ebook pa rin. But the eighth result is an academic journal. Yun yung maganda dito, academic journal. So in just one search box, you could search for both ebooks and for electronic journals. So, ang gagawin ko po muna is to download. Ano ba maganda dito? Ito na lang siguro. Number 9. Rethinking the Social and Social Media. But before you proceed to evaluating if this article is really good or if this is really relevant for your search, so syempre, ang una nyo pong binabasa is the abstract itself, right? So ganito po yan. So, isang search tip that I want to provide to you is this, we could provide the preview of the abstract of this particular article even without clicking it. Okay, and how you would do it. Ito yung mouse nyo. Meron tayong dalawa dito. This is the preview icon. This is the add to folder icon. Okay, if you hover your mouse sa preview icon, it will present to you the record of this particular article including its abstract. So dito pa lang po, pwede nyo na pong basahin if this particular article will really be relevant to your search term, okay? Okay, same thing with okay, ito na lang gamitin natin kasi dalawa yung kanyang full text is HTML and PDF. So same thing if you hover your mouse here. Okay? So makikita nyo po yung abstract of this particular article. Again, you could click HTML full text or click PDF full text and jump through to download it. Pero hindi ko yung siya gagawin. Ito yung papakita ko sa inyo. I click first muna yung detailed record. Upon clicking po the detailed record, okay, upon clicking the detailed record, we have an option to download the HTML full text and the PDF full text. So if you click here, okay, I will be redirected to the PDF viewer. So habang naglo-load po yan siya dyan, so you could always download naman the PDF from here. Click nyo po yung download PDF. And this is already the article po. Okay, yan na siya. So aside from that, so andyan na siya. You could also browse different issues po from here and the illustrations po from here. Okay? So much with that. I'll go back to the detailed record. Then let's proceed to the different functionalities and tools that will be useful for you as a student and as a faculty for your research. On the right-hand corner, we have what we call the Google Drive functionality. And this Google Drive functionality, the good thing about this is upon authenticating your Google Drive account, so click ko po yan. And so mag-authenticate yung Google Drive ko pero hindi ko na ini-authenticate. So just connect your Google Drive account. So magkakaroon na siya ng option to save to your Google Drive account. And this PDF full text will create a folder through your Google Drive account. Ang papangalan niya sa folder po na yon is EBSCO. And pag kinlik yung EBSCO folder, yung PDF full text po na yon is nandoon na po yung nasa loob po siya ng folder na yun. Aside from that, you could also add this article to your folder. So example, i-add ko siya. If your PC or laptop is connected to a printer, you could print the page of this web page po. Email, I'll discuss this later. So save naman functionality will just save the entire web page format of this particular article. Then the very important thing, especially for research, is citation. So if you click cite, you will be redirected to the different you will be redirected right now to the different citation formats available. If I further scroll down, so most of the time, ang most common naman is APA. So, ito na siya. Copy-paste na lang po siya. And this is already in APA citation format. So, moving forward po, so aside from citation, for mga high-level research naman, you could also export the citations po in your bibliographic management software like EndNote, ProCite, etc. So, pang high-level research na po ito. Then aside from that, you could also create note. So example, I want to create note. So example, I want to type, nyari, this is a good article. Okay. Okay. And if I click save, so ayan na siya. So saan napunta na Sir Bon yung note ko na yan? Again, you are not signed in yet to your EBSCO folder. So nandito siya. This is what we call your temporary folder. Scrolling down, okay, you have also what we call permalink. So permalink will give you an access to the direct link of this article. Again, this permalink is separate from the link that you see in the URL box or in the browser tab. Kasi itong nasa browser po, dynamic po yan. So nagbabago-bago yan. But this permalink is ito mismo yung exact direct link of that article. If I paste this or copy and paste this to a new tab, I will not be doing the search anymore. I will be redirected already to that page. In some cases po, example, I've shared this, let's say, to my classmate. Na kayon kasi nakalogin ako, kaya nag-automatic siya. But if I share it to my classmate na hindi pa nakalogin sa EBSCO, so what will happen? Ipo-prompt pa din po kayo ng system to log in to the user ID and password that is provided po to May Kawayan College for security purposes, for you to navigate and have the article na ma-view nyo po siya. Okay? So baka may magtanong po kasi sa akin about na. Then, because meron tayong HTML full text po dito, HTML also is what we call the online full text, meron po kayong listen and translate functionality. Of course, madali lang naman po ang translate. If you click translate and translate portions of this to different languages, this is primarily for foreign students and faculty if this is necessary. But if you further scroll down, so starting from here, yan yung the influence of social media po. So itong mga ito po, ito na po yung tinatawag nating HTML full text. So the good thing about HTML full text, so dahil online full text siya, so ang way lang po for you to have this one is to copy and paste it. But meron din silang functionality called text-to-speech functionality. So, for example, if I want to highlight this, okay, meron po tayo ditong tinatawag na listen or text-to-speech functionality. You could further filter it, piliin nyo kung anong accent po yung gusto nyo, American, Australian, or British accent. Maybe I'll use Australian accent naman. If I click play, so magkakaroon nyo ng violet and green. So, the file or the highlighted file is being converted to audio. I just don't know kung naririnig nyo lang po siya. But basically, ganun po yung functionality niya. But the good thing about this, the highlighted words that is converted to an audio file can be converted or downloaded in MP3 format. Nakita niya po, download MP3. So, yung madadownload nyo lang po dyan is yung highlighted file po. Yung highlighted words. And this is a good functionality. Kasi po dito nyo po mas ma-identify yung mga proper pronunciation of highfalutin words, etc. So, yun siya. Then, the last thing I want to discuss here before I go to ebooks is the email functionality. Diba, nilaktawan ko siya. So, if I click email, so the good thing about this, if you are a student or a faculty and you are a very email savvy person, and if you want to organize all of the articles po in email, so what you could do is maybe you could email this to you. So for example, email ko tong article na to sa sarili ko, personal email ko. So lagay ko po dito test MC library, kunyari lang po. Then may comment test. Okay, just a tip po ha, if available naman po ang PDF and HTML full text, wag niyo na pong include yung HTML full text sa email kasi magka-crowd po 'yan. The good thing naman available to in PDF. So what you could do is you provide na lang the PDF as a separate attachment sa email. Then the good thing about this, is you could select the citation format na i-email po sa inyo ng EBSCO. So example, I want to do APA citation format. So what does it mean to you? You're telling the system to send me this article attaching its PDF full text in an email in APA citation form with APA format, with APA citation format na siya, na ano, na citation. If I click send, just to prove to you, pakita ko sa inyo yung email. Okay. Okay. So, tingnan natin sa email ko kung anong itsura. Okay. So, if I, ayan, pansin nyo po. So, this is already the email. So, this is test MC library. Nilagay ko na subject. Comments ko yan. Then, a good thing, pinakita niya na sa inyo that the citation format is APA. So, ito yung APA niya. Citation format. Then, syempre, kapag na-used to na po kayo to sending all of the articles po in your email, we have included as well an additional information which is the permalink functionality na I have discussed already. So, if I click this, and syempre, naka-sign in ako right now, so I will be redirected po to the article kung saan ko po yung nakuha. Kasi kapag dumami na po yan, of course, syempre, you will be overwhelmed by so many articles kung saan nyo na po sila nakuha. And the very important thing is the full text is already attached, okay, to this particular email. So, di ba po, kompleto na siya. May PDF full text ka na, may citation ka na, may permalink ka pa. Kaya ako hinuli tong email kasi this is a very good functionality already for your, ano po, for your research, okay? And that is navigating po sa journals. Now, let's go back naman on how you would download or read, search, and download ebooks. So, if you go to the results list, so journals po yun ha. Now, let's go to ebooks. So, pili ako ng ebook ha. So, pipili na lang ako. So, I think maganda to, itong Pragmatics of Social Media, yung number 7. Kasi yung number 1 na download ko na yan sa iba ko pang mga training. So, all of the functionalities in journals are all the same. Meron lang additional functionalities for you to navigate the ebook ang sa ebook portion naman. So same thing, you could also browse the abstract of this particular siya. So ito yung abstract niya, same thing siya. But the good thing about this is you could access the okay, and the access naman po nito is you could browse the table of contents right from the results page. And dahil hyperlink po yan lahat, the good thing about this, you could click the kung saan chapter niyo po gusto and you could jump right in through this particular chapter ng ebook na to. Sir Bon, bakit meron diyang PDF full text, EPUB full text, and full download? So to explain further, there are two formats for you to download the ebook. First is PDF and next is EPUB. Okay? But not all books will provide you both PDF and EPUB formats. Okay? Ulitin ko yun ha. Hindi lahat ng ebook may PDF at hindi lahat ng ebook may EPUB. Yung iba EPUB lang, yung iba PDF lang. Okay? Then yung full download here will give you an access for you to download the whole book per se. So yung downloading whole book offline naman yung pinapakita nyo sa inyo. Sir Bon, ibig sabihin ba nito kapag nakita ko yung PDF full text dyan, is yan na po yung whole book in PDF format? No. If you click PDF full text, you will be redirected to its PDF viewer. So, gagawin natin yon. So, if you click PDF full text, pansin nyo, hindi magda-download siya ng full text, but you will be redirected to what we call the PDF viewer. So, all of the functionalities po is nandito na rin. So, same thing na diniscuss ko sa journals. Nandyan yung add to folder, save pages, email pages. Kaya hindi ko na rin po siya diniscuss kasi nandito na naman siya. Ang i-discuss ko yung ibang functionality na meron po ang ebook. First is content. So, tingnan nyo po dito. So, this, meron, okay. All of the ebooks right here to the subscription of May Kawayan College po is unlimited users. Yan, lagi ko naman sinasabi yon. Pero, because as an aggregator, so we are not a publisher, so we license content from different publishers and put it in our platform. So ibig sabihin, meron restriction, kung nakita nyo po, we were only given publisher permissions of 100 pages of this particular book for us to print, email, or save or download this, okay? Or download portions of this particular book. But copy and pasting is unlimited, and of course, download is not restricted. Okay, so if you further scroll down, so pansin nyo po, the different chapters of this ebook contains download link, which is a PDF file. So ito naman po is if you want to download po the chapter of a particular book. So let me give an example. So example ito, yung part 2, social media, if I click that, yung download chapter, oh, sorry, isang page lang siya. Hanap tayo ng Facebook na lang. Ayan. So, makikita nyo po. Dinownload ko tong number 9. Click yung download. So, pansin nyo po, pinakita niya sa inyo that the number of pages available for download is 100 pages. So, I could download the current page kung nasaan yung aking PDF reader. I could download the current page or the first 100 pages ng book na yan kasi I am only allowed for 100 pages. Or I could download the 13th chapter, itong chapter 9 yung sa Facebook, which is 20 pages. So, yun yung pipiliin ko. If I click download PDF. Again, if you download this, this is already in PDF format. Okay, so dinownload ko na yung 20 pages. So, ito ngayon yung result niya. Again, this is chapter 9, talking about Facebook, social media site. If I further zoom, makikita nyo po dito ha. Yan. Kita nyo, EBSCO Publishing. So, meron siyang timestamp. So, bakit PM yan? Kasi US time lang yung nakalagay dito. Okay? Via your school, May Kawayan College. So, meron din tayong security purpose sa pagda-download din po ng ebook. Okay? Then, aside from that, ano pa po yung pwede nyo magawa? Again, 20 pages yung dinownload ko. If I further scroll up, so yung 100 pages ko ngayon, 80 pages na lang. So, it's typically ano? Per session. So, if you download 13 portions of the book and 100 pages ka lang per session, so mababawas siya ng mababawas. And before I go with search within, let me give you another functionality that we have what we call auto-citation. So habang nasa PDF viewer po kayo, then if you want to have, if you want to copy 13 portions of the book in its online reader, we have what we call auto-citation. So, for example, ikakopy ko to ha. Kakopy ko tong abstract. Sorry, nasama yung isa. Ito na lang, ayaw niya. So, copyhin ko to siguro hanggang, yan, hanggang dito. Okay? Kakopy ko po siya ha. Ikakopy ko siya. Then, I'll paste it to Microsoft Word. Okay? So, paste ko siya sa aking Microsoft Word. Okay? So, yung nakita ko ay yung dinownload ko or yung kinopy ko po from that particular ebook page. If I paste it, okay? Pansinin nyo po, ito lang yung kinopya ko, di ba? But automatically, meron na siyang citation of from that particular ebook, which is the default is MLA. Ayun naman yung most common. And APA citation format, di ba? The good thing about this, it could help you to have citation while copying or certain or citing a particular clause or phrases or sentences in those in that particular book po. Okay? So I'll go back doon sa aking main screen. Then aside from auto citation, you could also search within the book. So example, I want to search about Facebook. Okay? So hahanapin niya yung part ng libro na minention po yung Facebook or topics about Facebook. So, you could jump right through dyan. And if you click My Notes, you could create a note from this particular ebook. Okay. Going back to... Pero, Sir Bon, okay. So, sabi mo, pwedeng, ano, pwedeng maka-download ng particular ebook itself. Okay. Balik tayo doon. Ano nga number yun? Sorry. Nawala ako. Yan, Pragmatics. Okay, so pakita ko naman sa inyo ngayon kung paano yung sinasabi kong full download. But before you download the entire book from cover to cover online, okay, to download it online, then ma-access mo siya offline, you must need to sign in first. And the first requirement is you need to sign in first to your My EBSCO's folder. So if you click sign in, okay, So, sorry, papakita ko muna sa inyo kung bakit siya requirement ha. So if you click full download, pansin niyo po, irerek ko yan, pangakalagay dito, download ebook borrow. Okay, Sir Bon, nakala ko ba you will download the ebook from cover to cover and access it online? Yes, that's it. That's the functionality. But the downloading ebook or the full download na sinasabi niya po dyan, it's like you borrow this particular ebook from your library, then you could access this particular ebook for a period or certain number of days. Okay? So, after that particular period, you access it offline, mag-expire yung ebook, then you need to return it to the library. So, auto-expire na siya. So, papakita ko sa inyo kung ano yung sinasabi ko, ha? If I click sign in, magsa-sign in ako sa aking folder account. Okay? So, again, the first requirement for you to download the ebook is for you to sign in to your My EBSCO folder. Again, this My EBSCO's folder is your own unique folder. Hindi po ito yung ibibigay ni Sir Alvin na user ID and password, ha? This is your own folder within the subscription itself. So, but the good thing about this, if you have naman na Google account, wag nyo na pong pahirapan ng sarili ninyo, click nyo lang yung sign in with Google, connect EBSCOhost with Google, then yung Google account nyo po, yan na po ang inyong EBSCOhost folder. Pero kung wala po kayong EBSCOhost, so kung wala kayong Google account, you could create your account po manually by going, scroll down, click nyo po yung create one now. Fill upan nyo lang po yan para lang kayo nagkakreate ng Facebook account. But you need to fulfill the parameters for you to create a stronger password. Kaya nga better pa rin na option that if you have a Google account already, click nyo na lang yung Google account nyo at connect nyo na lang yung account nyo sa EBSCO. Pero dahil meron na akong folder, signing ko na lang yung folder ko. Okay? And if I click sign in, how will you know if your EBSCO's folder creation is successful? Your first name should appear on the upper right-hand corner of your screen. Ayan, pansin nyo. Sign out na yung nangyari dito. Then, ang nakalagay dito, not Bon. So, ito na yung first name ko. Okay. Now, I could now full download that particular book. On what way? Kung makikita nyo po dito, ha? Sabi dito, download ebook or you borrow it. To borrow this ebook, you'll need to select a download duration. Andiyan naman siya. So, the maximum download duration for now is 7 days. So, default po yan. So, you could download the or borrow the book for a maximum of 7 days. This is already defined by your library. So, pwede namin pag-usapan ni Sir Alvin if you want this to be extended. And if the ebook for if the ebook has two formats, whether it's EPUB or PDF, nakita nyo naman po that if you're using desktop, so PDF format is kumbaga recommended. And kung EPUB naman is mobile device. And the next requirement for you to download the ebook is you must have, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina for my introduction, that you must have what we call Adobe Digital Edition. So, pakita ko lang po muna kung ano tong Adobe Digital Editions. Okay? And this Adobe Digital Editions, okay? So, this Adobe Digital Editions po is free. Again, libre po ito. So, this is a free software for you to manage your ebooks po. Again, this is software that you could download the ebook for now. So, kapag na-enhance na po yung app that could accommodate ebook downloads and viewer, so, kaya, hindi nyo na to, kumbaga, magre-redirect na po tayo lahat doon. But for now, Adobe Digital po muna tayo. It could be downloaded both for your desktop, PC, and even to your mobile phones. We have also a dedicated mobile app din na Adobe Digital Editions na pwede nyo rin pong i-download po sa App Store or Google Play na nakikita nyo naman po dyan. Okay. So from here, i-download ko na siya dahil mayroon na akong Adobe Digital Editions. So I'll click full download. Then I will be, makikita nyo. So ino-open niya yung version ng file na nasa Adobe Digital Editions. If I click open it, so, makikita nyo po, magda-download na yung fulfilling pragmatics of social media. So, the good thing about this, so, habang dinadownload niya na po yan, kapag na-download ko na po yung entirety nito, okay, so, ayan na yung mismong libro, kita nyo po. If I turned off my internet, na hindi ko gagawin kasi mawawala tayo sa WebEx at sa Facebook, this ebook po can be accessible offline even without internet for 7 days. Okay? So ito na yung ebook ko, pwede ko na siyang basahin. Same thing goes po ha sa mobile device. You must access the subscription in your cellphone bago po kayo maka-download ng ebooks through your mobile device. Same thing, you download the Adobe Digital Editions app. If I go back to the library, so ito na yung dinownload ko po, yung Pragmatic sa 6 days. So meron din po ako ditong librong 6 days. Then, wala na yung isa ko. Meron akong 2 days dito. Okay. But anyway, kung makikita nyo po dito ha, ito yung ibang mga ebooks na na-download ko na po, but yung iba expired na. So dahil natapos na yung download duration niya, if I click this, so unable na ako to open, expired na siya. So what you could do is to re-download na lang it from your subscription. So this is one way for you to save time, download as many ebooks as you can for you to access it offline. Okay? So going back, so ito po yung pagda-download ng ebooks. Sir Bon, ano pa bang advantage ng merong My EBSCO Host Folder account aside na pwede ako maka-download po ng ebooks? Okay? So from here, ang another functionality na papakita ko sa inyo kapag meron na kayong folder is you could now create what we call journal alert. So paano ba yon? If we go to publications, I'll go to Academic Search Elite. So ang publication alert po is will only work if you have an EBSCO host folder account. So it's like you are having a personal subscription already to your to that particular journal publication. So for example, pakita ko lang sa inyo ha. Sino ba na I don't know if every one of you is familiar with Psychology Today. So hopefully I think MC Library has this printed version. So if you want to have the online content of Psychology Today, if you click browse. Again, I'm looking po for certain journal title or magazine title. I'm not searching for articles. So you have now an access to Psychology Today from 1992 full text po to present. So click natin yung Psychology Today. So ang sabi dito, so this is being published 6 times in a year, okay? So tingnan natin kung ano yung latest issue na meron siya. So meron na siyang September to October. So if you want to be updated for the November-December issue of this, syempre wala pa siya, di ba? You could create publication alert. So ano ba to? If a journal alert. So if you click share, if you click email alert, so pansin nyo, you are now creating a journal alert. So ino-notify kayo ng EBSCO kapag dumating na yung version niya or yung full text version niya po ng November and December content. Fill upan nyo lang po yan, click yung alert to full text at i-email kayo ng EBSCO kapag may bago na po kayong issue po nitong Psychology Today. It's like na meron po kayong personal subscription through your subscription po ng May Kawayan College of Psychology Today. Yun po yung maganda dito. O Sir Bon, aside from journal alert, ano pa po ba ang advantage ng merong EBSCO host folder account? Aside from journal alert, you can now also create search alert. Ano ba yung tinype ko kaninang topic? Di ba po social media? Okay? And if I click search, okay? So makikita po ninyo dito sa social media, yan, so ito yung results natin kanina. Traditionally, ano po bang ginagawa ng mga faculty or ng mga students kapag nagsisearch sa mga databases na ganito? First is they search for social media, 'di ba? Type nila. Bukas, ta-type nila uli social media. Next week social media na naman. Next month social media na naman. So you are keying in the topic every now and then and you are getting maybe the same results or added results. So why not EBSCO help you for you to be updated if there will be new publications or new articles related to your topic, 'di ba? So, ang gagawin nyo lang po dito is you must create your own search alert. So, paano nyo gagawin? From the result page, click nyo yung share, click nyo po yung email alert. So, now you are creating what we call search alert. So, ayan na siya. Okay, fill upan nyo lang po yan. Then, set the frequency if you want to be updated once a day, once a week, bi-weekly. And if you want to see articles published within the last 1 year, last 6 months, etc., then click save alert. So yun po yung kinaganda on creating your both journal alerts and search alert. Okay. Okay, para hindi lang po, para sulit din po yung presentation ko po right now. So let me give like 2 or 5 minutes po of your time for me to discuss lang very quickly the interface po for high school. Okay, para at least sa recording natin kompleto siya. So this is the summary of the entirety of the functionalities of the EBSCO's platform. So pakita ko lang po very quickly, I'll jump right through the Explora platform para kompleto yung ating discussion. So ito yung diniscuss ko kanina, EBSCOhost Research Databases. Now let's see the different resources available naman or the interface available for basic education. So let's start with sa elementary. So meron kayong database called Primary Search. So pakita ko lang basically yung interface. So this Explora platform, pansin niyo po, talagang pangbata po siya, 'di ba? So mapapansin po ninyo the topics are very intuitive or the very kumbaga visually engaging. So meron tayong different topics dito like from arts, music, animals. If I click animals, so pansin niyo po, I will be redirected to the different pictures of animals. That could be a good topic to your research in elementary po. And the African elephant. Kung makikita nyo po dito, yan, yung African elephant. So, ayan na po yung ano, mga result page. And good thing, meron din siyang search topic. Parehong-pareho lang po siya with EBSCOhost. Ang kaibahan lang po niyan is primarily the interface is different to engage beginning researchers. So, ayan lang po yan siya. So, if I click search other databases, pakita ko naman po yung itsura nung sa high school. Again, elementary po yon. Ito po yung sa high school. So, tina-target namin dito is up to grade 10 only kasi usually senior high school is really more high-end research na. Kaya nire-redirect na namin sila sa EBSCOhost platform. So, from here, kung papansin nyo po, pareho lang siya ng sa elementary, pero the topics are more in-depth like arts and literature, biography, business and government. So, if you click business and government, so here are the different topics related to business and government. If I click accounting services industry, so I will be redirected yan to the topics related to accounting services industry with its topic overview. Same thing, kung makikita nyo po, almost same lang yung functionality niya because if you click an article or a result, all of the results makikita nyo parehong-pareho lang po yan sa EBSCOhost. It's the way that the interface present lang, especially yung basic search page. So, if yan, pansin nyo, andito rin yung mga Google Drive, etc. Okay. So much with that po. And that ends the training orientation po. And I'm seeing a lot of messages, I guess, or a lot of questions po right doon sa ating chat box. And now I open now the floor for ating question and answer po. And thank you very much for listening to this particular training orientation. Okay, so let me thank you very much for listening. So I'll be checking the chat box for in a while. So and I'll stop recording this.